Welcome to part two of the organic chemistry introduction. In part one, we went over all of these topics. Now, let's go over functional groups, do some examples, and I'll help you avoid a common mistake students make. A functional group is a specific type of substituent, meaning it is still attached to a carbon in the carbon chain. Before we go over all the common functional groups, it's important to know what an R group is. An R group stands for the rest of the molecule. Here's an example of a functional group. If we wanted to write this as a generic structural formula, this carbon chain would be the R group, and the X stands for one of these halogens. Let's go over the most common functional groups. First is an alkene. This is the structural formula, and here's an example. As you can see, an alkene refers to the double bond. Next is an alkyne, which refers to a triple bond. Onto an alkyl halide. Alkyl, meaning it consists of carbon and hydrogen, and halide, meaning it's a halogen. Next is an alcohol. An alcohol has an OH bonded to a carbon chain, or R group, meaning the rest of the molecule. An ether has an oxygen in the center and is surrounded by two R groups. The R groups can either be the same or different, shown by R prime. The apostrophe or prime means it's a different group. You'll see that in this example, this R group is different from the other. An epoxide has a triangular shape, with the oxygen being at the top of this triangle-shaped carbon chain. A ketone has a carbon that is double bonded to oxygen, and that carbon is attached to two R groups, either the same R groups or different ones. An aldehyde is very similar to a ketone. The only difference is that it has a hydrogen instead of two R groups. A trick to remember this is that aldehyde has an H in it. A carboxylic acid still has the same carbon double bonded to oxygen, but now there is an OH instead of an R group or hydrogen. An ester has a similar structure. It just has an R group attached to the oxygen instead of a hydrogen. An amide now has a nitrogen attached to the carbon that is double bonded to the oxygen. An amine still has nitrogen, but it does not have a carbon double bonded to an oxygen. To remember the difference between an amide and an amine, it's hidden in the name. An amine has the minimum amount of atoms, so it's the one without the oxygen. And this is a phenyl group, where a benzene ring is attached to an R group. Note, another functional group name is aromatic. This describes a benzene ring. Okay, here is a potential quiz or test question. We are asked to identify each functional group in the following molecule. We have a benzene ring, which is aromatic. This OH tells us it's an alcohol. Here we have two R groups and an oxygen in the center, which is an ether. And on top, note, there is actually a hydrogen here, making this an aldehyde. Okay, try these two on your own, and then I'll walk you through all of the answers, plus I'll let you know what common mistakes to look out for. So one common mistake I see is that students think this is an alcohol group, but it's actually a carboxylic acid. Always check what that OH is connected to. If it's connected to a carbon that is double bonded to an oxygen, then it's a carboxylic acid. If it's connected to an R group, or really a carbon chain, then it's an alcohol, like in this case. We also have an amine right here. We have a benzene ring, which is aromatic. For the second question, I often see students confuse an aldehyde for a ketone. So this is an aldehyde because there is only one R group, and there actually is a hydrogen right here. Now, for a ketone, there are two R groups attached to a carbon that is double bonded to an oxygen. And we also have an alcohol right here. Make sure to check out more videos to help prepare you for what's to come in organic chemistry. Also, if you need more help, I recommend checking out the description box because there you'll find other helpful resources that I handpicked just for you. And remember, stay determined, you can do this.